today's video lecture of maths. In today's lecture, in the chapter decimal, we are going to learn two concepts. First, equivalent decimal, and the second concept which we are going to learn, that is like decimals and unlike decimals. Both are very easy concepts to understand. Pay attention very carefully. Equivalent decimal. See the word equivalent. Have you heard this word before? Of course, yes. Why? Because we have learned this concept equivalent in the previous chapter fraction. We have learned equivalent fractions. Means what? Equivalent fractions means what? The fractions which look different but their value is same, or their values are same. The fractions which looks different but their values are same. Such fractions are called equivalent fractions. Correct? Similarly, in this chapter decimal, we have to learn decimal, equivalent decimal. Decimal which looks different but their values are same. Okay, see, in the equivalent decimal, we saw that 1 upon 4 was same as 5 upon 20. Right? 1 upon 4 was same as 5 upon 20. Means, if we multiply this by 5, 5 1s are 5 and 5 4s are 20. Are we getting? Right? So, this 1 upon 4, though they are 1 out of 4 and 5 out of 20, they are same. Their value is 5 upon 20. Its value is 1 upon 4 only. Understand? Similarly, in this equivalent decimal, we will see some decimals which looks different but their value is same. And in which way their value is same, how they looks different, let's see. See, observe these two figures. In the first figure, it is big square and it is divided into 100 small squares. And out of 100 small squares, how many squares are shaded? 10 squares are shaded. So this 10 upon 100, that is 10 hundred, then this can be written as 0.10 in the form of decimal, right? As we have seen in concept 100. See the figure which is below. It is also big square, same like of same size like first figure. Okay, it is divided into 10 equal parts, and out of 10, one part is shaded. That is 0.1. 1 upon 10 means 0.1. Okay. Now, if you observe both the shaded portion in both the figure, are they same? Are they equal? Yes. They are equal, right? That means what, you know? 10 upon 100 and 1 upon 10, both these fractions are same, and so 0.10 and 0.1, both these are equal. Okay, 0.10 is same as 0.1. Understand? Similarly, if there is 0.20, will be same as 0.2. 0.50 will be same as 0.5. Correct? What is difference in this? What is pattern in this? Here, in the 10th place there is 1. Here also 10th place there is 1. Just 1. 0 is there extra. Okay, so though here 0 is written after the number, means at the end of the decimal places. See, even though the zeros are extra in this, at the place of 10th, here also 1, here also 1, here also 2, here also 2, right? That means their value is same. We have seen 0.10 and 0.1, both are same. So similarly, 0.20 will be equal to 0.2, okay? So these fractions or these decimals, though they look different, their value is same. And which way it is same, why it is same, we have seen in this figure. Okay. Now see, let's solve the practice 6.6, in which the question is identify the Let's solve the practice 6.6. Okay, see, it is on page number 109 and solve that in the textbook only, because you have to just put a tick in front of the equivalent decimals and you have to put cross in front of the decimals which are not equivalent. Okay, now see, let us write first example 0. So see here, what we have to do, here pair of decimals are given and we have to identify whether these pair are equivalent or not. Okay, these two decimals are equivalent or not. Okay, now see here, 0.3 is equal to 0.30. Are they equivalent? Yes, because see, how to understand whether they are equivalent or not. See, in this 10th place there is 3. Here also in the 10th place there is 3. The difference, that is just there is 0 at the end. But if in this decimal, if the 0 is in the at the last, okay, in the last, then its value is nothing. Okay, so you can write, if there are 5 zeros, 4 zeros, doesn't matter, they are equivalent only, equal only. Okay, so 0 in the last doesn't matter. So this 0.3 and 0.30 are equivalent, so put T in front of them. Okay, second, 0.5 is equal to 0.05. Are they equivalent? No, because why, you know, here see 5 is in the 10th place, but here in the 10th place means first place after decimal point, there is 0. It is not 0, here 0.5 and here 0.05. If there should be 5 zero, then they may be equivalent, but here there is 0.05, so they are not equivalent. Okay, next, 0.60 and 0.6, are they equivalent? See, after decimal point first place is 6, here also after decimal point first place is 6. Here there is 0 at them, but it doesn't matter, they are equivalent only, their value is same only. Okay, 0.21 is equal to 0.210. See, 2121, are they equivalent? Yeah. 0.56 is equal to 0.056. Are they equivalent? No. Okay, 0.740 and 0.74, starting with 7474, so they are equivalent. Understand? 0.3 and 0.30, are they equivalent? Yes. 0.09 is equal to 0.090. See, after decimal point 0909. Okay, at the end you can add any number of zero, that doesn't affect on its value. Okay, so they are equivalent. So remaining two example solve by yourself. Understand, this was the first concept, equivalent fraction. Let's see the second concept in this chapter, that is equivalent decimal, not fraction. Let's see the next concept, that is live decimal and unlive decimal. These also two words, like and unlike, we have heard in the fraction. Correct? Do you remember? Like fractions and unlike fractions. So what is mean by like fractions? Such fractions whose denominator is same. See, this is the group of fraction. If you observe this fraction, their denominators are same, means 10, 10, 10, 10, right? Their denominator is same. So these fractions are called like fractions, and opposite of this, if denominators are different, then those fractions are called unlike fractions, right? Similarly here, what should be same in the decimal? What should be same? Then it will be like fraction. Like decimal. What should we say? Decimal places should be say. Decimal places means what? If the fraction is like this, 91.25 and 43.63. Okay. Observe these two decimals. Their decimal places in this first decimal number. Decimal places means the digits or places after decimal point. Okay, they are called decimal places. Now here after decimal point, how many digits are there? Two digits. That means the decimal places are two. Here also in this decimal places are two. Correct? So in both these decimal, their place decimal places are equal, same. So they are like decimals. Okay. Again one example I will give you 350 and 4.278. Here decimal places are 3, correct? And here after decimal point also there are 3 places. In both these decimals, their decimal places are 3, same, equal. So they are like decimals. And opposite of that, 2.65, and here another decimal is 0.8. If you observe these two decimals, here decimal places are 2, here decimal places is 1, correct? So here decimal places are 2, 1 means their decimal places are not equal. So they are unlike decimal. They are unlike decimal. Similarly, see another example. 5.2 and 26.498. Okay, here decimal place is 1, here decimal places are 3. The decimal places are not same. So these two are unlike decimals. Now further of that, we can convert these unlike decimals into like decimals. Understand? We can convert these unlike decimals, these two decimals, these two decimals, we can convert into like decimals. Now how we can convert those unlike decimals into like decimals? Do you have an idea? Which digit should we put? See here, now there is only one decimal place, here there are two decimal places. That means to make them like, here we want two decimal places. So how can we make here two decimal places? Which digit we can put here so that their value should not change? Such digit we have to put here by which their value should not change or should not be affected. Okay, such digit we have to put. Which digit you will put from 0 to 9? 0. We have to put 0 at the end. Okay, not here. So if when we put 0 at the end, here also now became two decimal places. Okay, so now they became equivalent. Now here see, there is one decimal place, here three decimal places. How many zeros we need to put here? Two zeros in the end, at the end. Okay, so here now became three decimal places, here also three decimal places. Their value became they became like decimals. Understand? So if the decimals are unlike, we can convert them into like decimals. And we need to convert when we have to do the addition of decimals, that we are going to see afterwards. So now let's solve the practice 6.7, which is based on this concept of like and unlike decimals. Okay, practice 6.7. Open your textbook, page number 110. See the first question, practice 6.7. Which of the following pairs are like decimals and which are unlike decimals? So now see first one. 23.36 and second is 56.49. Secondly, 345.369 and 0.86. Third one, 6.3 326 and 36.33. In the first two decimals, here see how many decimal places are there? Two. Here, two. So, they are like decimals or unlike decimals? Yes, their decimal places are equal, so they are like decimals. Here, downside write down, like decimals. Okay? Second, 345.369 and 0.86. Here, how many decimal places are there? Three. Here, two. Are they like? No, their decimal places are not same. So, they are unlike decimals. Okay? See, third one. Three decimal places. Three decimal places. Equal number of decimal places. That means they are like decimals. Understand? Fourth one. Solve by yourself. See, the second question. Express each of following pairs as like decimals. As I told you while learning concept, teaching concept, we can convert unlike decimals into like decimals by putting zeros at the end. Okay, that only we are doing here in this question. Question number 5. (2.874, 3.9, 3.6, and 122.97). Okay, so here these are not like decimals, these are unlike decimals, but we have to express them as a like decimals. We have to convert them into like decimals, and you know how do we convert unlike decimals into like decimals? By putting zeros at the end. Okay, so now see here 3.36 43.945. Here three decimal places are there. To make them like, here also there should be three decimal places, and here there are two decimal places. So let's put one zero at the end. Okay, next 2.874 and 3.9. So here there are three decimal places, here there is one decimal place, so we need to put two zeros to make them like. And here two decimal places are there, and here one, so let's put 10. So now they have become like decimals. Understand? So in this way, for last one example in this question, you have to solve by yourself. Okay? So today we have learned these two concepts, equivalent decimal and like and unlike decimals. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask me. So thank you for today and have a nice day.